For this lesson, you need to open the sample file World Sales 10 from your Sample Files folder. In this lesson, you'll look at an alternative method of charting a non-contiguous range simply by hiding the data elements that you don't want to chart. Excel allows you to hide rows and columns in a workbook by effectively setting their width to zero. The default behavior of charts is to ignore these hidden rows and columns. It's also possible to override this default behavior and instruct Excel to chart hidden rows and columns. But let's begin by removing the Europe data series from the chart by simply hiding column C. To hide a column, you need to right-click on the column header button at the top of the column. So I'll right-click now and then select Hide from the shortcut menu. And you can see that two things have happened. First of all, column C is no longer visible. And secondly, we're no longer charting European sales on the chart. Let's now do a very similar thing to hide the February sales row in row 3. And when I do that, I will expect that February sales will also no longer be shown on the chart. So I'll click on the row 3 header button, then right-click and hide. And as expected, the February data series is no longer being charted, and also row 3 is no longer visible. Now sometimes you'll have hidden rows and columns, but you'll still want to chart the values in those hidden rows and columns. And there's an option in Excel that will allow you to do this. I'll right-click just inside the border of the chart and then choose Select Data to bring back the Select Data Source dialog. And notice there's a button in the bottom left corner of this dialog that says Hidden and Empty Cells. I'll click on that now and notice there's a checkbox saying Show Data in Hidden Rows and Columns. I'll check that box now and then I'll click OK and OK again. And you can see that the data in the hidden column C, that's the column that has the European sales in it, is now being charted. And also the data in hidden row 3, that's the February sales, are now being charted. Now let's unhide those hidden rows and columns. To unhide a column, you need to select the columns on either side of the hidden column. So I'll click on the column B column header and drag across to the column D column header. Then I'll right-click anywhere in the selected range and select Unhide from the shortcut menu. And column C is now visible again. You can do a very similar thing to unhide rows. I'll select the row 2 row header and then drag down to the row 4 row header. Then I'll right-click anywhere in the selected range and select Unhide from the shortcut menu. And row 3 is now visible again. All that remains for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name World Sales 11. And as usual, I'll save in the folder above my Sample Files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed lesson 5.15, Chart Non-Contiguous Source Data by Hiding Rows and Columns.